Now here in this example, now first of all let us see which of the following declarations are valid and what are the declarations that are invalid. So the first case we have taken, integer double brackets a new int 3 and 4, actually this is valid because here I am specifying the sizes again. The next case, integer double brackets a new int with 3 locations but this size is not specified, actually this is also valid, there is no compile time error will be there. But if you do something like this, integer double brackets a new int, you have not specified the number of rows but you are trying to specify the number of columns, so this is not valid. This is valid but this is not valid. The next is integer double brackets a new int, and now you are not specifying size of any one of them, this is also not valid. Now here in this case again I can declare that it is a three dimensional array like this also. I mean these brackets, the pair should be there, it can be in before a or it can be after a. So because we are having 3 pairs here, so it is saying that it is a 3 dimensional array. So when I am saying new int 3, 4, now I am declaring number of blocks, number of rows and number of columns is not specified and this is also valid. So we have to specify actually in this order, so we cannot specify randomly their sizes. Either you have to specify all of their sizes or you cannot specify randomly. Say for example here this is valid but this is not valid. So again here 3 and 4 is declared, that is 5 it is valid, it may not be declared, that is also fine. So if I say I am declaring a 3 dimensional array like this and the memory allocation is like 3 and here this is number of blocks, number of rows is not specified, number of columns are specified, this is not valid because before declaring this you have to, before specifying number of columns here again you have to specify this number of rows. Okay, so clearly you can see what are the valid declarations of 3 dimensional arrays here and what are not valid. Now when you initialize an array in Java, so all the arrays are initialized by default value which is actually the 0. For example here I have created a 1 dimensional array which is integer brackets a new int with 3 locations. Okay, now here you can see if I am trying to print what is the value stored at index location 0, it is going to print the value as 0. So what does this mean? It means that a is referring to an object. Now in this object we have 3 memory locations like this and by default all these 3 memory locations are going to store the value as 0. Now if I try to print system.out.println a, so what happens is in case of C language when I try to print a, so it prints the base address. Let me show you too, let me write it down. So in case of C and C++, if I do something like this, integer a with 3 index locations and I do printf a, so what happens here is in case of C and C++ there will be 3 contiguous memory allocations. If the address of first location is 1000 and size of integer of 2 bytes, so next address will be 1002, the next address will be 1004, and here A will be storing the base address which is 1000. So if you try to print A, it is going to print the base address of the array which is 1000. But same is not valid for Java. So in Java what happens is arrays are declared as a class. Okay, so because it is a one dimensional integer array, so there will be a class for one dimensional integer array again, so which is this opening bracket and I, okay, at the rate some hash number. Okay, so it is going to print opening bracket I at the rate some hash number. Okay, now let us also see with two dimensional array also. Look at this example, and I have written some programs, some lines here where I try to declare 3 arrays here, and we are just trying to see what are the valid one and what is invalid. Now you can see here the very first case, I am declaring integer a new int 3, so this is perfectly valid. That means I am creating here a which is referring to an object which is having 3 locations, and by default for every location the value stored is 0. So if I do system.out.println a of what is the value of the index location 0, this is by default 0. But if I try to do system.out.println a, okay, now here again this is just going to print the class name, so class name here will be opening bracket I because it is an integer array. Again if you will be having a character array, it will be having a different class name. If you are having a double array, it will be having a different class name. So for all the different types of arrays which are of different data types, they will be having a different class name. So if I am doing in system.out.println a, opening bracket I will be the class name, at the rate some hash code. So maybe it may be 10ABC11 like this. Okay. Now here in this case, this declaration is also valid because I'm specifying that it's a two-dimensional array, and in this two-dimensional array, so for example, we'll be having two rows here, and in every row we'll be having something like this. Okay. Now, if I try to do system.out.println b, see, if I just try to print b, what happens here is, again, it is a two-dimensional array, it will be having class name, and the class name here is opening bracket I, at the rate some hash code, okay, some hash code which is written hexadecimal. Now, if I try to do system.out.println data at index location 0, now this 0th index location is again pointing to an object of one-dimensional array. So if you are trying to do this, it will print opening bracket I at the rate some hash code 11A112B, something like this. Okay. Now system.out.println b 00, yani from 0th index location to this 0th index location, by default the default values are 0. So it is going to print the value which is 0. Okay. Now if I try to do integer opening bracket c new int 2. Right, so this is also valid as I specified you, this is also correct. That means I'm trying to create a two-dimensional array, but I'm not specifying what is these elements. I'm just trying to create two-dimensional array. It is not pointing to those locations. Now, if I try to print system.out.println c, okay, because it is a two-dimensional array, so class name will be opening bracket I, and it's because of integer type, at the rate some hash code. If I try to print system.out.println c of 0, yani get what is the data stored at the 0th index location. As you can see, this is not referring to any object because here the second size is not given. But here the second size was given. Okay, so here the second size is not given. So if I try to do c of 0, it is not pointing to any object. So this is going to print null. Okay, now again, if I try to print the data which is present in 0th and 0th index location, this location actually does not exist. So this is going to give you null pointer exception. Okay, there will be null exception here. Okay, so this is how you can declare and how you can print the data in two-dimensional arrays also. Let me take more example. Let me discuss more about two-dimensional array. So let me rub it up and I'll come back again.